Welcome students, I'm Mr. Boscarini, and for our unit on forces and motion, we're going to start dealing with speed. First, the definition. Average speed. The average speed of an object is defined by a ratio, the ratio between the distance traveled by that object and the time it takes to travel that distance. As you can see, I've specified average. I didn't just write speed. There's a reason to that we're going to see in a moment. Now, this is our formula. It's our first formula that we're going to deal with in this unit of forces and motion, and it's written in words. Now, in physics, as in general in every science, we do prefer represent formulas with symbols. This is very much like word and symbol equations in chemistry. Word equations are simpler to understand, but a symbol equation will give you more information. In this case, we will rewrite the same formula as V equals D over T. V stands for speed, D stands for distance, and T stands for time. As I told you, average speed normally is not the same thing as actual speed. And we can understand this with a very simple example. As you, for instance, you travel from home to the school, let's say by bus, you can measure the average speed of a bus by simply measuring how long the distance is from the bus stop to the school and how much time it takes. And that is the average speed of a bus. On the other hand, it's obvious that the bus from time to time will go faster, will go slower, will speed up, slow down, stop to allow people to get in and get off. So for that reason, we say that the average speed is different from the actual speed. So let's see how we can use the previous formula to calculate the average speed of different objects. Let's start with a very famous example, Usain Bolt. He's called the world's fastest man, and he's the world record holder for the 100 meter dash. So when he broke his record, Usain Bolt traveled a distance of 100 meters in an astonishing time of 9.58 seconds. And now we can work out the average speed of Usain Bolt during that race. Using the previous formula, we enter the distance, 100 meters, we divide by the time, 9.58 seconds, and you can find out that the average speed of Usain Bolt was 10.4 meters per second. As you can see, meters per second is the unit that we're going to use for measuring speed. We also use kilometers per hour, miles per hour, but the standard unit is the meter per second. Talking about very fast things, the Thrust SSC, more a jet plane than a car actually, but it's a land vehicle that holds the world record for speed. In the 1990s, this jet-powered car broke what we call the sound barrier by traveling a distance of 1,000 meters in 2.94 seconds. Again, we use the formula. We do the ratio between 1,000 meters over 2.94 seconds, and you get 340 meters per second, which is the speed of sound. Now, so far, we use the formula distance over time to find the speed. But what if a problem asks you to find the distance or to find the time? Now, if you don't feel so comfortable with algebra, there's a very easy way to solve your problems, and that is what we call the magic triangle. Every time you have a formula which is given by a ratio, you can work out a triangle very much, pretty much like this one. We will see other examples with density, with pressure, and with other physical quantities. In this case, you will see that the triangle is filled with a distance on top, speed here, and time here. And how does this work? Simply, you have to see what is the quantity between these three that you need to find. And then you simply cover it. Usually you will cover it with a finger, but now since this triangle is pretty big, you will need your whole hand. Let's say in this case, I want to find the speed. You see it's distance over time. If I want to find distance, it's speed times the time. I want to find the time, it's distance over speed. Now let's see this thing in practice. In a problem with speed, there are three types of questions which might be asked to you. How fast? How far? And how long? In the first case, we're looking for speed. When they ask you how far, they're asking for distance. And we're asking how long, they're asking for time. Now let's see again how we can use the magic triangle to work out the formulas to answer these three questions. How fast? We're looking for speed. I call the V, and there you go, distance over time. And that's a formula we had at the very beginning. How far? Asking for distance. I call the distance, and there you go. Speed times the time. And that's our formula. Finally, how long? I want to find the time. Distance over speed. And that's our formula. It's that easy. So what was the learning goal of this lesson? By the end of this lesson, you should be able to measure the speed of an object by using the formula we've seen at the beginning, or to work out distance and times by using the magic triangle. Coming next, we will see velocity and the difference between speed and velocity. And finally, what happens when speed or velocity change, that is, acceleration.